हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज़ एपिसोड 234। Jio and MediaTek have launched Gaming Master 2.0, the second edition of their eSport tournament that will feature the Indian version of the PUBG Mobile Battlegrounds Mobile India. The game is published by South Korean company Krafton and developed by PUBG Studios. The eSport tournament will have a prize pool of ₹12.5 lakhs and those who have interested in participating can register now. The debut season feature Garena Free Fire. As per the communication sent to us, it attracted over 14,000 team registrations. Instagram is rolling out new voice effects and text-to-speech features for Reels. Instagram will let creators use an artificial voice in the Reels to read anything instead of using their own voice. This feature will be rolled out to iOS and Android users. WhatsApp is working on a new feature to hide large scene from specific contacts. This new feature could be released soon. This feature will also prevent users from using large scene of backlisted contacts. According to the rumors, Realme GT 2 Pro, Find X4, OnePlus 10 Pro, Oppo N series phone and Reno 8 Pro to feature a 125W fast charging support. Rumors surrounding the launch of Reliance JioBook have been popping up for a while now. The laptop has today been spotted on the Geekbench database website. The Geekbench listing not only reveals some key specifications like the processor, but also hints at an imminent launch. Oppo tablet offers an 11-inch display with a 120Hz refresh rate. It is expected to be powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor. Oppo Tab features 6GB of RAM and a 256GB of storage. Oppo could launch the Reno 7 series in November or December 2021. A live images of the Reno 7 Pro model has leaked online. The smartphone is surrounded to sport a 6.5-inch Full HD Plus Super AMOLED display. OnePlus 10 design is going to be identical to the Oppo Reno 7 Pro. Oppo Reno 7 Pro live images have revealed the front design. The OnePlus 10 series is set to debut in the first half of 2022. Realme got into air purifier market earlier this year. Further expanding on the vast portfolio of wearable and smart home products, Realme is offering as a part of new venture that was Realme TechLife air purifier that sold for ₹7,999. Now Realme is looking to launch a pro variant of the same at twice the price of ₹15,999. With the increased price also come multiple advanced new features. For starters, there is a better HEPA filter with a higher lifespan of 3,500 hours. A notable improvement over 2,800 hours offered by the standard model. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition 5G is rumored to launch on January 4th. Before Samsung confirms the launch date, the device details have leaked online. This phone will come in 4 colors. The marketing poster also reveals that Samsung claims of long-lasting battery life on the S21 Fan Edition. The device triple camera setup will also come with some camera filters for shooting portraits. No less than 43 Samsung products were honored with the CES 2022 Innovation Award, including 4 that won the Best of Innovation Awards. CES will be making an in-person return on January 4th and Joey Han, President and Vice President of Visual Display Business and Strategy Electronics. Samsung has revealed its plans for 2022 in the smartphone sector. The South Korean tech giant has set its objective to ship 334 million smartphone units worldwide. According to the plan, Samsung is gearing up to manufacture an impressive 285 million smartphone units in-house while outsourcing the production of 49 million units in its joint development manufacturers. Samsung aims to produce 54 million units of the flagship Galaxy S series and 13 million units of the Galaxy Z folding lineup. Chinese electric car maker Zipping teased a new sport utility vehicle on Friday with a launch scheduled for next week. The car is likely to be successor to the Zipping current SUV, the G3 and G3i. It will be launched at the auto show on November 19th. Sony PS5 production has been reportedly cut owing to a component shortage. The company has reportedly cut its previous production forecast of 16 million down to 15 million. Sony is apparently having trouble with not just parts supply but also shipping logistics as well. MediaTek has always been an underdog when pitched against the competitors like Qualcomm and Samsung. But its new Dimensity series of 5G chips have changed the game. The company's CEO recently announced that they are now the largest smartphone processor maker globally, proving it's an extraordinary growth. However, the MediaTek share has been close to nothing in the flagship smartphone segment. And the MediaTek Dimensity 2000 processor sets new Antutu record with a 1 million score. While MediaTek and Qualcomm has been known rivals in the smartphone shipment market for many years now. The latter had always been the leader in the segment, but now MediaTek has finally become the largest smartphone processor maker this year. The smartphone market in India saw a 12% year-on-year decline in the third quarter of this year. During this quarter, only 48 million units were shipped despite seeing 4 consecutive quarters of growth. Although this decline can be attributed to factors like ongoing component shortage along with an unusual high third quarter performance last year. But comparing quarter 3 2021 to quarter 3 2019, we can see that the market saw a 3% growth as various channels also stock up the festive season despite the semiconductor shortage. South Korean began testing a new system that will be used in controlling urban air mobility vehicles. These tests will determine whether the new mode of transport will be used for travel between major airports. The new air taxis could potentially cut travel time between the major airports by 2/3 in the capital city of Seoul. Back in 2020, the country had announced a roadmap that details the timeline of the commercialization of urban air travel by 2025. The local transport ministry also expects the service could reduce time travel for distance between the 30 to 50 km for an hour on road just 20 minutes by air. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.